Hello friends! Today's tutorial shows how to create address labels from a list of addresses in an Excel file. First, we'll discuss how the address information should be organized in Excel. Then, we'll create the labels using mail merge. Next, we'll customize the line spacing and font. Finally, we'll print the labels. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to Word for Mac and the recent non-subscription versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for the web or Word for mobile. For best results, ensure that the addresses in your Excel file are organized with logical headings in the first row, such as name, street address, city, state, and zip code. Don't include any additional headings, such as addresses, above these headings. To begin, open a new document in Word. Then select the Mailings tab in the ribbon. From there, select Start Mail Merge, followed by Labels from the drop-down menu. When the Label Options dialog box appears, select your label vendor. Note that this menu will be called Label Product on Mac. Next, select your product number, which should be displayed on your label's packaging. If your labels aren't listed here, you can create a custom label option by selecting the New Label button. When the Label Details dialog box appears, give your custom labels a name, and then enter the dimensions, and select the OK button. After selecting your labels or creating a custom label, select the OK button. Next, select Select Recipients, and then choose Use an existing list from the drop-down menu. When the Select Data Source dialog box appears, locate and select your Excel file, and then select the Open button. When the Select Table dialog box opens on a PC, or the Open Workbook dialog box opens on a Mac, choose the individual worksheet containing the addresses within the Excel file, and select the OK button. PC users can now select Edit Recipient List, and then uncheck anyone you want to exclude in the Mail Merge Recipients dialog box. Once you've chosen your exclusions, select the OK button. Please note that this option will be unavailable or grayed out in Word for Mac when mail merging with Excel files. Now we're going to insert the address fields. To begin, ensure your cursor is in the first label, which will be blank. At this point, you may see other instructions using the address block to insert the fields. However, I don't recommend using the address block because it has a persistent glitch that inserts unnecessary and difficult to remove blank spaces before the name on every label. Instead, we're going to use Insert Merge field. The headings from your Excel sheet will appear as fields in the Insert Merge field dialog box. Select each field that you want to include, and then select the Insert button for each one. Finally, select the Close button. If you're on a Mac, you won't see the Merge field dialog box. Instead, simply select the field from the Insert Merge field's drop-down menu. Next, place your cursor between the fields and press the Enter key on a PC or Return key on a Mac to move the fields down to the next line as necessary. If you live in the United States, insert a space or comma and space between the city and state. Also, insert a space between the state and zip code. If you live outside of the United States, please adjust these steps as necessary to meet your postal requirements. Next, select update labels to populate the fields into all of the other labels. And then select Preview Results to see the addresses in the labels. Afterwards, reselect Preview Results to return to the field view. To customize the line spacing, press Ctrl plus A on a PC or Command plus A on a Mac to select all the labels. Then, right-click one of the first label fields on a PC or Control-click one of the first label fields on a Mac, and then select Paragraph from the shortcut menu. When the Paragraph dialog box appears, you can remove the extra space between the lines by checking Don't Add Space Between Paragraphs of the Same Style. You may also want to move the addresses away from the left margin of each label by adding a small indent in the inside indentation text box. When you're finished, select the OK button. Despite the adjustments we just made, you may notice that the addresses appear too close to the top of the labels. You can correct the situation by adjusting the spacing for the first field, which in our case is the name field. To begin, click away from the text to deselect all the labels. Then, right-click or control-click the name field in the first label. And then select Paragraph from the shortcut menu. This time, when the Paragraph dialog box appears, uncheck Don't Add Space Between Paragraphs of the Same Style. And then add space in the Spacing Before text box. I'm going to add 12 points. Now select the OK button. And then reselect Update Labels to add the top space to all of the other labels. If you want to customize the font or font color, once again press Ctrl plus A or Command plus A to select all the labels. Then, right-click or control-click one of the fields in the first label and select Font from the shortcut menu. When the font dialog box appears, choose a new font, size, and color as desired, and then select the OK button. And select Preview Results to see the new font choices applied to the addresses. When you're ready to print your address labels, load your label sheets into your printer, and then select Finish and Merge, followed by Print Document from the drop-down menu. When the Merge to Printer dialog box appears, select OK. And when the Print dialog box appears, select OK on a PC or Print on a Mac to print all your labels. Or enter a 1 in the Pages text box followed by the OK or Print button to do a test of only one sheet before printing a large batch. If the test page is successful, you can return to Finish and Merge, Print Document to print all the sheets. Finally, save the labels as you would a regular document if you want to reuse them in the future. All the steps we just performed are listed on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below along with my complete playlists, How to Use Microsoft Word, and How to Use Word for Mac. If you found today's tutorial helpful, please leave me a comment with any other Word topics you'd like me to cover in the future. Subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials, and of course I'd appreciate a big thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching.